Warning, the following video contains explicit language which may be offensive to some viewers or inappropriate for children. The content within this video is intended for mature audiences only.
Give me Spitz versus Garcia after the Adrian Broner fight. Not Terrence Crawford. Who do you want to see? Spence posted that the next fight was going to be him and Terrence Crawford. That was a long time ago. Didn't happen. Another fucking lie. Then we got the Crawford versus Brooks situation that's coming up. But let's start from the top here for a second. Danny Garcia started with Danny Garcia. Now, Danny Garcia was offered a pretty penny to fight Terrence Crawford. That fight didn't come in fruition because Team Garcia did not answer back to that offer. They simply ignored it. Now, word on the street is he kept Crawford waiting, but Danny Garcia's people made excuses and said they heard nothing from Terrence Crawford or anybody from the other side of the street, so to speak. Now what I'm about to do is provide proof and about the excuses and the lies and the contradictoriness of Mr. Garcia and the rest of this bag chase division, is what I call them at 147, and why I'm fed up with the 147-pound division. While he has the most talent, it's still a bullshit division. The offer presented by Moretti during the phone call with Angel, $3 million guaranteed plus upside of pay-per-view revenue. The plan was for Crawford and Garcia to headline Top Rank's first pay-per-view show. Of course, Garcia aligned with PBC, but it was a totally professional discussion, Moretti said. He said he would discuss it with Danny. Never heard back. I appreciated him taking the call. I think that the door is always open. Absolutely. But of course, they never heard back. So enters Amir Khan, who gets $5 million to fight Terrence Crawford. Now, there are some people who said that Amir Khan was going to be somewhat of a test for Terrence. But of course, after Terrence whooped his ass, people changed their tune up. And then they say, why would they give him $5 million? Well, Garcia was going back and forth with Terrence Crawford saying, I'm not going to go back and forth with you. I'm fighting somebody else, but you have no notable wins. I already best you for free. Why wouldn't I do it for some millions? Canelo's potential earnings from the fight was about 15 to 20 million. Amir Khan's earnings from the fight was an estimated 13.1 million. Sound like a bag chasers to me. Bunch of them. Amir came all the way up to get his ass knocked the fuck out. But that's the point I'm simply trying to make. Amir Khan was already used to making them M's, as they like to say. He commanded a lot of money. And if you understand the business side of boxing, Amir Khan definitely was going to earn more money than Danny Garcia, no matter how you see the two fighters as equal or one is better. Danny Garcia's highest payday, I keep telling y'all this, was $1.2 million with Zab Judah and Sean Porter. He was offered $3 million plus venue. Amir Khan chased that bag and got $5 plus venue revenue, and he ended up getting $7 million. $5.5 million was offered to Terrence, and Terrence obviously made a killing and made like $8 million. Now I hear is another bag chase from Bob Arum trying to throw Terrence Crawford to the wolves in a two-fight deal against Conor McGregor. One a boxing and one a MMA. Psh, what a joke. Moving right along. Let's get back to the Crawford-Brook fight. This is why I say I'm not going to entertain and pay watching this fight. Is because simply, Kell Brook is a washed-up fighter. Though people See that ass. The last victory he had was a tomato can at 154 or 160, wherever the fuck he was fighting at. Now he wants to come all the way back down to 147, so he says, I don't fucking believe him, until he actually drops down to 147. Because once before, when the talks heated up about it, he was not ready to come down in weight because he couldn't lose the weight. Now, we know he got his eye busted by Triple G, his other eye socket busted by Errol Spence, two killers in the ring. What the fuck you think Terrence Crawford gonna do? Go after that fucking eye. And probably beat the shit out of him if they end up fighting. Now, everybody know the common denominator in all this bullshit talk is Manny Pacquiao. Everybody wants to chase Manny Pacquiao. Errol wants the Pacquiao fight. Terrence Crawford wants the Pacquiao fight. Sean Porter wants the Pacquiao fight. Keith Thurman ended up getting the Pacquiao fight, and he got his ass whooped by a 40-year-old man who can still box, obviously. Now, Terrence Crawford was close to getting a fight with him, I believe, this year. But my thing is this. Sean Porter now says Pacquiao always had been number one on his list. He's had conversations with Terrence Crawford, or was finna have a conversation with Terrence Crawford, and he would like a rematch with Errol Spence. Those are his top two fighters that he would like to see once these COVID-19 reset happens. Keith Thurman, who had fought Manny Pacquiao and hasn't fought since, says he wants smoke now all of a sudden with Terrence Crawford. That's another fucking joke. All these dudes is sitting back on the couch, analyzing shit, talking shit. Ain't none of them gonna do shit. First of all, you had an opportunity as well to fight Terrence Crawford. You was offered a sweet three-fight deal, $10 million worth, but you went for the other big bags to fight Manny Pacquiao. You ducked Errol Spence. You could have had a very, very big fight at a huge venue at Cowboy Stadium, perhaps, but you refused to do that as well because the fight wasn't ready yet. Now, all of a sudden, the fight is ready. Now you want to fight Errol because he got two belts. Now you want to fight Terrence Crawford. What was the difference between then and now? Not much. We're talking about anywhere from 15 to 11 months of you talking shit. And now, you think the fans want to entertain you fighting Terrence Crawford? Would I watch? I'll watch that. Is it a pay-per-view right now? Well, it's a title fight. I mean, you are now considered a pay-per-view fighter. Would I pay to see that one? Not if you're going to be not the same fighter. Danny Garcia looks like he's the lucky one. It's strap season, but yet Danny Garcia is a titleless fighter. We all know that Errol Spence is going to fight Danny Garcia this fall. That's going to happen. I don't give a fuck what you hear from anybody else. Fuck what you heard. I'm telling you what the fuck I know. Errol Spence is going to fight Danny Garcia. This was the plan all along. If it wasn't for the car accident, they would have fought in January. The whole fucking time. We thinking we going to get Crawford and fucking Spence next because it's strap season, right? Fuck no. We don't know who the fuck Manny Pacquiao is going to actually fight. We don't know if it's going to be Sean Porter. We don't know if it's going to be Mikey Garcia. Or if Danny can shake that fight. He might even skip Earl and take the Pacquiao fight because he might think it's an easier fight. But from what I'm hearing, that might be a no-go. Who knows? He might fight a tomato can. Talking about Mr. Pacquiao. He can do it because, I mean, he has no mandatories. Now, Errol, he has mandatories. Terrence Crawford has already fought his mandatories. Now, these are the men I'm discussing that are supposed to be the top five according to Ring Magazine. And none of these motherfuckers are really fighting each other. I will not pay to see Errol Spence fight Danny Garcia. Danny Garcia, to me, has not earned a title shot. Adrian Granados, quite frankly, is not a world beater. He's a tomato can. He's not on the same level as Danny Garcia. I will give him that much props. Instead, he tucked his tail in between his legs. Instead of fighting Terrence Crawford for a belt and to get his biggest payday, he elected to fight a fucking tomato can that can't stop fucking drinking. And he want me to take this motherfucker serious? Get the fuck out of here. I'm not taking None of these motherfuckers serious. That's including Bud. And if Bud, and then Bud had the nerve to come out of his mouth and say he was willing to fight Conor McGregor. What is you fucking, come on, man. It's got to be a money grab. You motherfuckers ain't doing nothing but sitting back, talking shit, and talking crazy. None of you motherfuckers, I think, want to really fight each other unless it's a big amount of money to lose. It's basically like you selling y'all O's and shit, just like Keith Thurman did with Manny Pacquiao. I don't even know if Errol Spence and Crawford is even going to ever fucking happen. Now, we want to see either Errol Pacquiao. If not, why not it be Sean Porter rematch? If you're going to fight a titleless nigga, fight Sean Porter. In this reset, we should see nothing but super fights. Nothing but super fights. And if Terrence Crawford cannot get any of you guys over there, and if Keith Thurman is the only guy from over there that's willing to fight, then I would rather see him fight Keith Thurman over Kell Brook. But I would rather see him fight Kell Brook over fucking Conor McGregor. Who wants to see Terrence Crawford fight Conor McGregor? I wouldn't pay to see that either. It wouldn't even be entertaining to see Sean Porter and Keith Thurman to run it back. Pacquiao ain't running it back with Keith Thurman for damn sure, because he said he took too much punishment. So basically, you're going to be on the back burner. Keith Thurman is just talking shit. He's going to fight a tomato can on his way back if he ever fucking comes back. It definitely ain't finna be Terrence fucking Crawford. So all this shit I'm hearing about what Sean want to do, what Terrence want to do, I don't give a fuck, because it's strictly talk and I don't take none of these motherfuckers serious. Point blank period. They shit talkers, bro. We already know what's going to happen. 147 is fucking predictable. The timetable is set. The fight schedule is already fucking set, and they're going to get back to what it was. And that's all I got to say about that. I'm out.
My Lord, I'm in a bad situation again. One more time. First, forgive me for all my sins, past, present, and future. Niggas know what I'm saying. But that shit that I'm talking to you, niggas gonna be fucking up the days. Trying to tell you this here. Say what you want. I see an opportunity to eat. It's them niggas sleeping across the street. And I'm going to get out of here. On the ghetto block, in the end thing, strength ain't serving out the rocks. Baby, I want some peace, but I know nobody.